This week we're focusing in on the Vcarve inlay process of this clapperboard project. What we love about this technique is that you can incorporate it in a variety of ways to fit your own project. So stay till the end for a more detailed walkthrough in Vectric's Vcarve for a how-to on programming the toolpaths. Essentially, we're creating two parts. One is the pocket of the design, a recessed area in the body of the clapperboard, and the inlay, or the plug, which will be glued into the body of the design. I went ahead and made two glue-ups, one larger walnut glue-up for the body of the clapperboard, and a smaller maple glue-up for the chevron design. We'll square the sticks on the joiner and cut them to length. After gluing them up, I'll send them through the planer to level the material and cut them square on the table saw. First, I'll cut the maple insert. We'll zero our X, Y, and Z using our Auto Z and corner finding touch plate. I'll attach the material using composite fasteners. This is a great way to attach material to the bed, though you might choose to pilot the holes first when using hardwood to prevent splitting. We'll run the pocket clearing press first, and then the 60 degree V-bit to lessen the amount of material the V-bit has to remove. For the body of the clapperboard, I chose to use metal fasteners and piloted the holes with the CNC for my work holding technique. Check out the description below for a video on how we did this. We'll re-zero our Z-axis with the same 60 degree V-bit and run our V-carve toolpath. Then we'll run our quarter inch bit for the V-carve clearing, the acrylic insert pocket, and the exterior profile. I added large, strong 2D tabs to the exterior profile to hold the clapper body to the drop material. If you follow this order of operations, we don't have to CNC the parts for the inlay, glue it up, and then put it back on the bed again to CNC the exterior profile cut. I'll remove any extra of the raised material on the edges of the maple inlay. And now you can see how the two parts fit together. After we do a little cleanup on both parts, we can glue in our insert. I'll brush in the glue for an even distribution. Using a few homemade clamps I was gifted recently by a friend of mine, I'll clamp it up and let this sit overnight. We happen to have a large bandsaw in our shop that's handy for resawing and for projects like this. If you don't have access to one, no worries. You can use a CNC to remove any excess maple, similar to as if you were leveling your spoil board. We also happen to have a drum sander. A palm sander with a low grit would work just fine too. Now I can cut out the parts from the job material. Again, if you don't have a bandsaw, a coping saw or jigsaw would be a great alternative for this. I can sand down my tabs on the belt sander or using a flush trim bit to clean them up. I'll do some finish sanding with my orbital sander and break the edges with a small chamfer. And we're ready for finish. Here I'm using a satin wipe-on poly, though it's really up to you and your aesthetic preference. Now we can move on to other elements of this project, including CNC machining the acrylic insert and CNC plasma cutting the custom hinge plates. Thanks everyone for watching. Keep an eye out for more Pro Maker videos and stick around if you'd like to learn more about your Vcarve file setups for this project. See you all in the shop. Welcome to our Vectric walkthrough of the Vcarve Inlay toolpath programming. Here's my Vcarve file of the clapperboard project. I've just drawn out my design in all 2D vectors. Let's preview the current toolpaths we already have programmed. We have a pocket for the acrylic or whiteboard insert, the exterior profile, and the hold down pilot holes. Let's touch base on the concepts of how these parts come together. This is an extremely helpful diagram made by Vectric, and you can find a link in the description below. The female part is pretty straightforward. First, we'll determine how deep you'd like the engraving to be on the clapperboard, and this will be an important point of reference for later on. If you increase or decrease the flat depth, this will adjust how much space you have for your glue gap and for the air gap above the inlay for the bandsaw blade to cut through. We recommend doing a few tests first. You can adjust as necessary to make the parts fit just right if you need a larger or smaller glue gap. Now I'll go to my Vcarve file and select the chevron design on the body of the clapperboard. Let's create a Vcarve toolpath. Pretty straightforward. We'll make this a flat depth of 0.2 inches. I'll select the 60 degree V bit as my tool and the quarter inch bit as the clearing bit. Let's preview those toolpaths in context now. Here you can see those large tabs that will hold the body in place while we do our inlay glue up and for us to trim off the excess material. I'll go back to my 2D window, select the inlay design, and copy the vector, then save the file. Now we can create a new file for our maple inlay. I'll make my material slide slightly larger than the design. I can paste the design into our new file. This will be for our maple plug part of the inlay. In order for the parts to fit together, we have to mirror the design. I'll flip this horizontally. Then I'll draw a rough box around the outside of my material, accounting for any hold down techniques I might be using. I'll leave some space on the edges for the composite fasteners. Now we can create our Vcarve toolpath. I'll select the chevron design and the box around it. Let's make the start depth of 0.15 inches. I'll make the flat depth about 50 thousandths, which will leave some room for the glue in the bandsaw blade. There's still some wiggle room here, so you can make adjustments as you need to. We'll just be sure that our router bit selection matches that of the Vcarve toolpath from the body of the clapperboard. Let's preview those toolpaths. Looks like we're ready for lights, camera, action. Thanks everyone for watching. For more information about CNC router parts machines, you can check us out at cncrouterparts.com. I look forward to sharing more techniques, projects, and build videos with you very soon.